I think the tour generally was good, you know, from the moment we started the camp into coming into today's match. I think, you know, we had some stuff to work on, and I think we started working on that quite well. Of course, today was disappointing for us for the mere fact that we do believe that we were better than the opposition, but today we sort of you know, went into to sort of a slouch mentally, and it did impact on the performance as a team, you know. It was a good lesson for us, I believe. You know, coming into to future competitions, we'll have this sort of time period in between games, and you know, another thing we have to learn to respect and to treat every opposition the same. And you know, as again, it's a learning experience for the team. So hopefully, we could go away from this taking into account the things that we did well and the things that we didn't do so well, and build on it in the future.
Coach mentioned after the game that he was particularly interested to see how the team would respond back to back in terms of facing quality opposition. You mentioned the fact that maybe the guys were more mentally ready for Argentina, or looking forward to that. How do we you know, address something like that now?
Yeah, I think in the circumstance, we could probably say that, you know, the game was behind closed doors today. It wasn't, you know, a lot of eyes on, and probably we mentally switched off, which for us is a big mistake, you know, especially when you come away from a game thing knowing that the opposition wasn't better than you, you know. But again, it's something that we have to learn to be better at mentally, and mentally prepare ourselves better. You know, we will be going into games where the opposition would be probably of less quality, and we have to be able to stand and treat them with the same respect, and for us as well to treat the games with the same mental approach as if we're going to play Argentina or, you know, or Iran or France, Germany, whatever it is. So I think we definitely learned something, a big, big lesson today.
You as captain now, a leader of this team, what are some of the things you would like to see improve on? I mean, obviously there's a lot of room for improvement. That's why we're here, that's why it's a whole process. But on and off the pitch, a lot of things that can be, you know.
Of course, as I said before, we have a young team. We have a very young team at heart, and of course a very inexperienced team internationally as well. You know, we have, yes, a different mixture of professionals coming from various places, and also we have, you know, the local pros as well, and sometimes it is hard for them to go from playing in front of, I don't know, maybe 50 to 100 people to 62,000, you know, a lot of people are just getting that experience, and it is a factor, it is an experience to behold, and some of them never had it. But with, I guess, coming into the national team and having more of these games where we can play some big oppositions, you know, we'll be getting that experience leading us up into our qualifiers and our regional tournaments as well. So hopefully, you know, we could take away from this a good lesson and go back and build on it, because I do believe that the team has all the capabilities, the talents, they know how to be better and to do better, of course, in the tournaments coming up and heading into the World Cup qualifiers.
There was mention in the local newspaper today that there is that feeling, based on observation, that the players have taken to the head coach, and really, you know, you have situations where players have a coach that they really want to play for. How do you feel about this, and in terms of what he's trying to do with the team?
Well, I think he's done really well since he's come into the team. You know, he's brought a bit of freedom and also a bit of organization to the team. Of course, yes, we still have, as a team that is growing, we have some stuff to work on, but I believe everyone has accepted that responsibility to play for the country and to play for the coach. He's given us that confidence and that belief in our ability, and we also believe in what he has to offer. So you know, I think we can only, once we keep together as a group and try and push one, and I think we can only go on to bigger and better things.
And finally, being one of the senior men in the team now, there was a period in the last 2006 campaign when, you know, you were a junior player, professional, the likes of Latipi, Lawrence, Stern John, Dennis Lawrence in the team. Now you've taken their shoes. How do you deal now and try to help the younger guys like the Trevin Caesars who came on today, the Willis Plazas and the likes of these players?
Well, the only way you can help them is by, first off, the way you care about yourself and the way that you care about the work that you're doing. If they want to be able to be at that level all the time, they're gonna have to work at that level wherever they're at, you know. And I think you know, it's fantastic to see them in the squad, and I do believe that they have all the potentials to go on and become great professionals and great players for Trinidad and Tobago. So hopefully with their inclusion and the way that we work all the time, they can, you know, raise their levels higher and continue to be that household name for Trinidad and Tobago.
And you know, obviously a lot of interest in terms of what happens with Kenwyne Jones on the professional club stage. Anything you can tell us in terms of what we can expect for next season?
Well, what I can tell you is that I'll be having a little bit of a rest and then going back to work wherever the transfer window takes me. It takes me, that I don't know yet, but hopefully I'll be moving forward and playing football and enjoying it.
Perfect.